NASA's Kepler Space Telescope found a super Earth, but don't start planning your interstellar vacation just yet. Hey guys, Amy here with you on DNews, talking distant worlds that might be like our own. The big exoplanet news from NASA last week is that the Kepler Space Telescope has found the first near-Earth-sized exoplanet. Called Kepler-452b, we know this exoplanet is 60% larger in diameter than the Earth, and that it orbits in the habitable zone of a G2 star like our own Sun. The habitable zone is the region where it's warm enough for liquid water to exist on the surface. But we don't know about the planet's mass or its composition, so it might be rocky like the Earth, or it might not be. But we're still calling it by the tantalizing name of Super Earth, which sort of raises the larger question. What is a Super Earth, and as we keep finding different types of exoplanets, when should we actually be getting excited? The most commonly found exoplanet types bear some similarity to our own giant planets: Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. We hear a fair bit about hot Jupiters. These are gas giants like Jupiter that orbit their parent stars closer than Mercury orbits our Sun, making them scorchingly hot. There are also gas giants found around distant stars, Jupiter-like bodies orbiting at Jupiter like distances from their host stars. Another neat exoplanet type that falls roughly under the gas giant banner is a group called chthonian planets. These are former gas giants who migrated so close to their parent stars that their atmospheres have completely roasted away, leaving behind a rocky or metallic core, possibly covered in molten lava. Then there are the exoplanets classified as being somewhat Earth-like, somewhat being the most important word. The main type we hear about are super-Earths, which sound like bigger, better versions of the Earth, but aren't. Super-Earths have masses roughly 10 times greater than the Earth's and are potentially rocky planets, so really it's just a mass distinction. Some of these super-Earths could be gas dwarfs or chthonian planets. Far more compelling are exo-Earths, planets with a similar mass and radius to the Earth that have an atmosphere and also orbit their star's habitable zone. But this doesn't really mean they're earthly. Some models show both Venus and Mars living in our Sun's habitable zone, albeit on the fringes, and neither of those worlds are teeming with life like the Earth is. So an exo-Earth could be a distant, sulfur-rich hell world. And because so much of the search for life on other worlds is about finding water as a necessary ingredient for life, a very interesting type of exoplanet is a water world. These planets are entirely covered in water, likely from surface ice that melted as they drifted close to their parent stars. Unfortunately, we haven't actually found a true Earth orbiting another planet. Earth-like, maybe, and planets with some similarities to Earth, yes, but we're not moving to another Earth anytime soon. But that doesn't mean we should stop looking. So knowing that these exoplanet discoveries are more scientifically fascinating than indicative of another world for us to live on, are you guys still really excited about exoplanets? And while we're talking about space, should we be mining asteroids for precious metals? Trace talks about one asteroid in particular that could be worth trillions.
Pointing these tools at UW158 tells us that it might have a core of platinum, maybe as much as 90 million tons of it, thus the high price tag. But getting there, mining it, and bringing it back is also expensive.
We'll have a link to that video in the description if you're on mobile. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to DNews for more videos every day of the week.